To get back to your project, you should have that tab open. So you should have a tab at the top for Scratch and then a Machine Learning for Kids. So if you click on that and then click back to project. And here's what we're going to do. We're going to train our model. We've made a Scratch project, but we know that it needs help, right? So it only works for those two statements, one happy, one sad, and we want it to work for many different happy and sad statements. So what we're going to do is go back to train, and we're going to train our model to recognize happy statements and sad statements. So if we click here on train, let's follow the instructions. Click on the plus button on the right and add your first bucket. So we're going to add a new label. We're going to type in happy as our first label and add. And now we get this box where we can add many examples of happy statements. So let's add an example. So I think you are awesome. So we're going to reuse that from our Scratch. But let's add more. We talked about I love you. I want to be your friend. You can type in a whole bunch. So what we're going to do is we're going to type in a minimum of 10 statements. I've added several happy sentences, so now I'm going to add a new label. So going over to the plus again. And for this one, I'm going to say sad. This will be my sad statements. So these are things that would make you sad. So something like, I don't like you very much. You are not very nice. And again, we want to add about 10 statements, at least 10 for the sad. So now you should have at least 10 sentences for happy and 10 sentences for sad. And what we'll do now is go back to the project again. What we've done is we've trained our AI model, and that's the word that we use. It's called a model, with our two different labels, happy and sad. Now what we want to do is go to the second step, which is to learn and test. And this is where we feed the examples to our AI model and have it learn. So let's go to the learn and test. Okay, so what have you done? You've collected examples of text for a computer to recognize when text is happy or sad. And we've got 10 examples of each. We are ready to start the computer training, so we're going to click the button below to start training it. So let's train it. This is going to take a minute or two. Okay, now we're at the testing stage, so let's put in something. I do not like you very much. Recognized as sad. That seems very good. I think you need to go away. Sad. I wish I could be your friend. So the idea here is that you're typing in sentences that are similar or very close to the ones that you added, but your AI is learning from some of the words within your sentences to understand these are kind of happy phrases and these are sad phrases. So it doesn't have to be exactly as typed in, but it's a model that is recognizing patterns of happy words and sad words. Let's try another sad. You make me feel grumpy when I see you. Sad. I think you are amazing. Happy. How about you make me happy? Okay, so that's not good. It recognized that sentence as sad with 72% confidence. 72% is not 100% confidence, which would be perfect, but 72% is still pretty high. To think that you make me happy is a sad sentence. So if you're picking up any sentences that really don't make sense, so recognizing when I say you make me happy as sad, then that means that we need to go back and add more. So what we're going to do is go back to the project and go to train. And just looking over my happy sentences, I didn't use the word happy anywhere. So you might want to add examples for sentences that did not perform well. So I'm going to add in, you make me happy whenever I see you. Make sure with your testing that you test a bunch of different sentences and then go back to your training and add more examples where needed. So once you've added more examples to cover those cases where it doesn't perform well, go back to project and go to learn and test again and train the new machine learning model. In the meantime, they have nice quizzes to test your knowledge while you're waiting for your model to train. Okay, so it is done. So what I'm going to do is go back to my project.
Click on Learn and Test again.
So now I'm going to test it. So let me try it with You Make Me Happy. 67% confidence. So at least it recognizes it's happy. Whenever I see you, I feel happy. Happy. So I fixed that one error with my model. So you want to make sure that you test thoroughly. And if you find in your testing that some of your sentences aren't being labeled correctly as happy or sad, you need to go back to your training, add more examples, and then go back and train it again and test it. So what have we done so far? We have trained an AI model, and then we had it learn, and then we tested. This is called supervised learning. So if you think about it, we've actually supervised how our AI model learns by feeding it some good examples and then testing it. When we found out that it didn't learn everything that we wanted it to know, we went back and trained it with better examples. That's what we mean by supervised, because we are looking on, essentially, right? We are looking at how it's being trained, what it's learning, and then giving it more examples so it learns the way we want it to learn. You've just completed training an AI model using supervised machine learning. What we're going to do now is go back to our Scratch and use our new model within our Scratch project to make it work better.